Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics, and in this video we will see the concept of supernode in the electrical circuit. So before we understand the concept of supernode, let's quickly see the nodal analysis technique in the electrical circuit, as it will help us in understanding the concept of supernode. So let us say we have given one electrical circuit, and in this circuit we want to find the current through all the three resistors using this nodal analysis technique. So this nodal analysis technique is nothing but applying Kirchhoff's current law followed by Ohm's law at all the nodes in the electrical circuit. So if you see this circuit, we have total three nodes. This is the first node, this is the node number 2, and this is the node number 3, which is a reference node. So in this circuit we will apply a KCL at this node number 1 and 2. So applying KCL at node number 1, we can write I1 plus I2 is equal to 3 ampere. So now if we apply Ohm's law, then we can write I1 as V1 by 2 and I2 as V1 minus V2 by 5, where V1 is voltage at node number 1 and V2 is voltage at node number 2. So if we simplify this circuit, then we will get this equation, that is 7V1 minus 2V2 is equal to 30. Let us say this is the equation number 1. Similarly, let's apply KCL at this node number 2. So we can write I3 plus 2 is equal to I2. Now we can write this I3 as V2 by 1 and I2 as V1 minus V2 divided by 5. So if we simplify this circuit, then we will get V1 minus 6V2 is equal to 10. And let us say this is the equation number 2. So in this way we got these two equation. So now if we solve these two equation, we will get V1 as 4 volt and V2 as minus 1 volt. And now if we apply Ohm's law, then we will get a value of this current I1 as 2 ampere, current I2 as 1 ampere and current I3 as minus 1 ampere. So in this way, using this nodal analysis technique, we can find the current through all the circuit elements. So now let's just modify this circuit. Let's replace this 5 ohm resistor by a 2 volt voltage source. And let's try to solve this circuit using this nodal analysis technique. So now if you try to solve this circuit using this nodal analysis technique, you will find some difficulty, because earlier we had a resistance, but now we have a voltage source. And we don't know what is the current that is flowing through this voltage source, nor we know what is the equivalent resistance of this voltage source. So instead of voltage source, if we have given a current source, then it is easy to apply this nodal analysis technique, because we know the current through this current source. But in case of a voltage source, we don't know the value of equivalent resistance or a current that is flowing through this voltage source. So in such cases where you find a voltage source between the two nodes, then the concept of supernode is quite handy. So when you are solving the circuit using this nodal analysis technique and you find a voltage source between the two nodes, then you can consider these two nodes as a single entity, and that is what is known as a supernode. So in case of a supernode, we consider this node 1 and 2 as a single entity, and instead of writing two separate KCL equations, we combine them in a single equation. So let's apply a KCL at this supernode. So at this end of supernode, we can write V1 by 2 minus 3 plus, at this end we can write V2 by 1 ohm plus 2 ampere, that is equal to 0. So we have combined two separate KCL equations in a single equation. So as we are considering this node 1 and 2 as a single entity, so we are not considering the current that is flowing through this 2 volt voltage source. So if we simplify this circuit, then we will get V1 plus 2V2 is equal to 2. Now if you see, the potential difference between this node 1 and 2 is a 2 volt. So we can write it as a V1 minus V2 is equal to 2. So now if we solve these two equations, we will get V2 as 0 volt and V1 as 2 volt. And hence the current I1 can be given as 1 ampere and current I3 can be given as 0 ampere. So now if you see here, the current that is entering into this supernode is 2 ampere and the current that is leaving out of the supernode is a 2 ampere. So the current that is flowing through this 2 volt voltage source is a 2 ampere. So in this way, using the concept of supernode, we can solve such problems. So now let's solve one more example based on this concept of supernode. So here we have given an electrical circuit, and in this circuit we want to find a current through this 1 ohm resistor. Let us say the current that is flowing through this 1 ohm resistor is Ix. And if you see this circuit, we have total 4 nodes. This is the node number 1, this is the second node, this is the node number 3, and this is the node number 4, which is a reference node. And let us say the V1, V2 and V3 are the voltage at this node 1, 2 and 3 respectively. There is a voltage source between this node 1 and 2. So let us treat this node 1 and 2 as a supernode. So let's apply a KCL at this supernode. So applying KCL at supernode, we can write V1 by 1 minus 1 ampere at this end, and at the other end we can write V2 by 1 plus V2 minus V3 add by 1, that is equal to 0. So if we simplify this equation, we will get V1 plus 2V2 minus V3 is equal to 1. And let us say this is the equation number 1. So now if you see here, the potential difference between these two node 1 and 2 is a 3 volt. So we can write it as a V2 minus V1 is equal to 3. And let us say this is the equation number 2. So now let's apply a KCL at this node 3. So applying KCL at node 3, we can write I2 plus 2 ampere, that is equal to 1, where I2 is nothing but V2 minus V3 divided by 1 ohm. So if we simplify this equation, we will get V2 minus V3 is equal to minus 1. And let us say this is the equation number 3. So in this way, we got a 3 equations. Now here, as we want to find this current Ix, so we need this voltage V2. So let's write this equation 2 and 3 in terms of V1 and V3. So we will get V1 as V2 minus 3 and V3 as V2 plus 1. So let's put this value in equation number 1. So we will get V2 minus 3 plus 2V2 minus V2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So if we simplify this equation, we will get V2 as a 2.5 volt. And this current Ix can be given as V2 divided by 1. So we will get this current Ix as 2.5 volt divided by 1 ohm, that is 2.5 ampere. So in this way, when we are solving the problems using this nodal analysis technique and we find a voltage source between the two nodes, then the concept of supernode is quite handy. So I hope in this video you understood the concept of supernode. If you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.